currently a whopping 11 volcanoes in Iceland, marking nearly one-third of the nation's active volcanoes, are displaying various signs of unrest. This includes ongoing intrusions of magma at three volcanoes and one volcano which is expected to erupt later this month. In other words, like 2023 and 2024, 2025 is also likely to be another volcanically active year in Iceland. To help portray what I believe the intensity of volcanic unrest currently is at the nation's various volcanoes, I have placed them all on a 0 to 10 opinion-based volcanic unrest scale. This video will initially discuss the various volcanoes with the most significant amounts of unrest and work its way downwards. Starting off, we are likely only hours, days, or weeks away from the 8th eruption of the Reykjanes volcano on the peninsula, which goes by the same name since December 2023. All of these eruptions have occurred along a lengthy 15-kilometer-long fissure which developed on November 10, 2023 during a failed magmatic intrusion. Magma at 11 kilometers depth, which itself originates from molten rock in the upper mantle associated with the Iceland hotspot, is right now actively feeding a 5 kilometer depth shallower magma chamber south of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant. This magma chamber tends to empty to the east and produce an eruption when it reaches a volume of between 10 and 15 million cubic meters, and right now it has a volume of 13.5 million cubic meters. In other words, the Reykjanes volcano will almost certainly erupt again this year, if not multiple more times. Moving away from the Reykjanes Peninsula, 105 kilometers to the north-northeast is the Liushufol volcano. Since September 2024, a deep intrusion of magma has been ongoing at this complex, largely beneath and to the east of Grjótarvatn Lake. This is occurring at a depth of between 15 to 20 kilometers, generating occasional harmonic tremor, and an elevated rate of earthquakes, including several large enough to be felt by nearby residents. While this has not yet generated any uplift, it is worth keeping an eye on the Liushufol volcano despite the fact it has not erupted in more than 1,000 years. Heading back to the Reykjanes Peninsula, while a magmatic intrusion is not occurring at the Fagradalsfjall volcano at the present, it is still experiencing an elevated level of earthquakes which paralleled the direction of a failed December 2021 intrusion. The Reykjanes and Fagradalsfjall volcanoes so far have been dominant at alternating times in terms of receiving a deep magma supply source. Reykjanes received the vast majority of the magma supply between December 2019 to December 2020 and from October 2023 to the present, while Fagradalsfjall has been dominant between January 2021 and September 2023. There is a potential for Fagradalsfjall this year to become the dominant receiver of magma once again from the deep magma source, although the odds of it erupting in its current state right now are quite low. Heading to the center of the country, the Askjale volcano has been undergoing a slow, presumably basaltic magmatic intrusion at 3 kilometers depth since July 2021, and this intrusion is still weakly ongoing at the present. However, it appears that magma is merely pooling at those depths, generating an increased amount of earthquakes rather than actively intruding upwards. Also in the center of the country, the Grímsvötn volcano has been producing an increased number of earthquakes, earthquake swarms, and glacial floods termed eucalypts, which have occurred at an increased frequency, therefore signaling volcanic unrest. While these floods would normally occur at a rate of about once every 2 to 3 years, they have been recently occurring at a rate of once every 6 months. The Hekla volcano is sort of a wildcard volcano, as everything can seem perfectly normal leading up to an eruption, with the volcano only giving between 23 and 80 minutes warning before an eruption begins. Well, there is a weak piece of circumstantial evidence that suggests it might erupt by 2027. That being, the fact that the Rangarbotn River, which is directly fed water from springs that bubble up through the Hekla volcano, became completely dry as of August 29, 2024. This river has only become dry anywhere from days to multiple years before each of Hekla's eruptions, with water only coming back to the river in the hours to days before an eruption commences. Reykjavik and Eldey on the Reykjanes Peninsula have experienced an elevated level of earthquakes at times since 2020 that possibly signal deep changes to each volcano, but with the exception of a failed intrusion at Reykjavik in October 2020, the only recent unrest each has experienced are occasional earthquake swarms. The Bárdarbunga volcano beneath the Vatnajökull ice sheet has been experiencing elevated levels of uplift since May 2024 and also had a brief amount of magma movement that was potentially detected on January 14, 2025 during an intense but short earthquake swarm. Katla is also displaying a tiny amount of unrest through the generation of an increased rate of earthquakes and occasional earthquake swarms during the last few years. And for our last volcano showing a level of unrest, the Hofsjökull volcano has been producing an elevated level of earthquakes since 2021, a pattern which is still continuing at the present. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, William Hayes, for supporting this channel.